Very good evening, all you medicals. Kindly update in the chat box. Is audio video fine? Can we start with the session? Is audio video fine? Very good evening, all the students. I will try my best in the upcoming couple of minutes. We will try to crack the whole concept of middle year. All the students, I feel very good evening, Dr. Mohammed. I feel everything is fine, audio, video on the other side. So let us start. In the beginning, I will just introduce the best, the most innovative concept of integrated teaching by DAMS. In the upcoming years, where I take my word, this will be the epitome of teaching, where everything will be adapted to the new pattern. Very good evening, Dr. Hema, Dr. Madhuri, very good evening. Let us start with the concept of middle year. Next 1 hour, I will try my best to give you the concept of middle year with which you will crack all the important ones, MCQs of upcoming NEET examination. So let us start the game. Everyone, focus your eyes. Myself, Dr. Deepak, KIM faculty, I will be teaching you the concept of middle year in next 1 hour. So let us learn the concept beta. This is the first 3D orientation. My basic concept, what I feel we should learn with a 3D imagination. So I will be drawing the line diagrams, and this methodology you should follow in the upcoming days. So we are starting here beta. This is my external year, this is my middle year, and this is my inner year. So we will be somewhere concentrating on the middle year segment. So we'll be concentrating on the middle year segment. Now everyone do imagination. If we go with imagination, I'm confident you will crack all the important concepts. Everyone, every student sitting me across the globe, every student, just do imagination. You people are sitting in a room. The room in which you people are sitting is your middle ear, beta. Everyone, the room in which you are sitting is your middle ear. Very good evening, Dr. Ashma, Dr. Hema. Let us concentrate now. Just focus your eyes. The screen on which these concepts are coming is your anterior wall. Beta, everyone, first 1 minute for the imagination. The screen is the anterior wall. Your back is the posterior wall. Your back is the posterior wall. Your right side is the right side is your lateral wall, and your left side, left wall. Imagination, everyone. Dr. Priyanka, very good evening. Concentrate on the board. The room in which you people are sitting is a middle ear, beta. Room in which you people are sitting is the middle ear. Now do imagination with me. Your right hand, the wall on the right side is your lateral wall. Wall on the left side is a medial wall. Wall on the left side is a medial wall. On the anterior, the screen is your anterior wall. Your back is the posterior wall. Roof and the floor, same. Am I understandable? So we are doing an imagination. You are sitting in a room in which we are having six wall. Let us learn the concept beta. I am writing for you. Everybody concentrate on the board. I have six wall: anterior wall, posterior wall, medial wall, lateral wall, roof, and the floor. My promise, after 1 hour, no need of touching any textbook as far the concept of middle year is concerned. I am having three special terms. In the anatomy, I am using three important terms. The medial wall, always remember beta, the most prominent bulge on the medial wall. Always remember, we use permontory. So your authors mention a word permontory for the medial wall. I, for teaching my concept, I will be giving you the maximum bulge on the medial wall is known as permontory. But in this lecture, whenever I am using the word permontory, just take it granted we are talking about medial wall. Very good evening, everyone. It is permontory. Very nice, Dr. Krutika, for updating in the chat box. It's permontory. What is a lateral wall known as? We call it as tympanic membrane. We use a word beta, tympanic membrane. Dr. Jagjit Singh, very good evening. Let us focus on the screen, learn the concept. And the roof, what is the roof known as? There is an English word, tagmen. Now wherever I'm using tagmen in anatomy, tagmen means roof, upper part. What is the other name of middle ear? Sir, tympanic cavity. So what is the other name of roof of the middle ear? We use a word, tagmen tympani. But we at DAMS, we never believe in mugging up the things. We can't mug up all the 19 subjects, but I try to learn, try to crack the words. Tagmen means upper part. tympani, middle ear. So whenever I am using the word tegmen of mastoid, it is self-explanatory. We are talking about roof of the mastoid cavity. Am I understandable? Are you getting this point? Six wall, three important names for one tree. Maximum bulge on the most prominent bulge on the medial wall. Lateral wall is known as tympanic membrane. Roof is known as tegmen tympani. Now, which are the important chambers, beta? Do imagination. The screen in front of you is the anterior wall. So, what is the chamber anterior to anterior wall? Chamber anterior to anterior wall is infratemporal fossa. Everyone do imagination with me. Anterior to your middle ear will be your infratemporal area. Posterior to your middle ear is your mastoid cavity. Posterior to your middle ear is your mastoid cavity. Very good, Dr. Devia, is infratemporal fossa. Medial to medial wall is your inner ear. Beta, before teaching the concept of middle ear, I'm just giving you orientation. Okay, you people are sitting in the middle ear and which is surrounded by six chamber. What is lateral to lateral wall? Obviously, it is external ear. What is medial to medial wall? It's inner ear. Nothing to mark up. Very simple concept. What is above the roof? Above tegmen tympani, we have middle cranial fossa. Beta, just make proper notes with me. Self-written notes. Beta, no shortcut to the hard work. Middle cranial fossa above the roof. And what is beneath the floor? Jugular bulb is there, and we have to do research of all these chambers. We will learn all the concepts. Six wall, three important terms and important chambers. Am I understandable? This is a 3D image I am showing you. This is my tympanic membrane, which is attached on the lateral wall, and on the medial side is my oval window, which I will discuss in detail later. Am I understandable? Are you getting this point? So this is the basic orientation of my middle ear. Let us crack the first wall, lateral wall. Lateral wall known as tympanic membrane. All the students concentrate on the board, beta. Now focus your eyes on the board. If this is my tympanic membrane, which ossicle is attached? Which ossicle is attached to the tympanic membrane? Always remember, malleus is attached. Can you appreciate, beta, in this image I'm showing you? Now focus your eyes on this image, beta, everyone. Yes, Dr. Shikha, this absolutely, it is jugular bulb. This, what is this one? I want every medical should reply what I'm showing you. This arrow is, yes, what is this one? This is a malleus. Excellent. From this malleus, there is one thickening anteriorly, one thickening posteriorly. The thickening anteriorly is known as valvular fold. No need of marking up, beta. If a fold is coming from malleus, to beta, kya naam rakhenge hum uska? Anterior malleolar fold. One is coming posteriorly, we call it as posterior malleolar fold. Antemalleolar fold, posterior malleolar fold. So two folds are there. With the help of these folds, we divide the tympanic membrane into upper one third, lower two third. Yes, what is upper one third known as? Upper one third, we use a word, pars flaccida, and the lower two third is known as pars tensa. So beta, this is your pars flaccida. Concentrate on the board, every student. And the lower word, this is pars flaccida, and this is your pars tensa. Absolutely, yes. It is upper one third, lower two third. What is the important MCQ one liner? What is the diameter of tympanic membrane? 10 mm. Always remember diameter. In your books they mention length or breadth. No need of mugging up. Just remember diameter is 10 mm. While thickness of tympanic membrane, every student, thickness of tympanic membrane is 0.1 mm. Everybody revise with me. Diameter of tympanic membrane is 10 mm. Thickness is 0.1 mm. In one of your JIPMER examination 2017, they mention one statement. Everybody listen, very nice response. Shikha beta, excellent. It is 10 mm. Is your diameter, and the thickness is 0.1 mm. Thickness is 0.1 mm. Now focus your eyes on the board, beta. Every student, just concentrate now. Anterior malleolar fold is longer than posterior malleolar fold. The beauty of these lectures, always draw line diagrams and write everything on the line diagram, beta. Longer than posterior malleolar fold. Anterior malleolar fold longer than posterior malleolar fold. Is a true statement, beta. Anterior malleolar fold is longer than posterior malleolar fold. When I throw a light on the tympanic membrane, I always get a reflection. What is this reflection known as? We use a word, cone of light. Beta. Where is the cone of light? Anterior inferior bone of flight is in anterior inferior. Now every student focus your eyes, stop writing, concentrate on the board. Anteriorly is your cone of flight. What is the importance of anterior inferior segment? Anterior inferior segment. Being a dance student, when I try to add all the points on a single platform, anterior inferior. Cone of flight is there? Yes, cone of flight. Yeah. Meningotomy. When I puncture that tympanic membrane, we use a word meningotomy. Which patient? Obviously, there is an extra fluid in the middle ear. What we call it as glue ear. If there is a glue ear, I want to puncture the tympanic membrane. Where I puncture? I puncture in the anterior inferior segment. I puncture in the anterior inferior segment. Very simple, straightforward concept going on. Anterior inferior. What is the third importance of anterior inferior? Grommet insertion. Where we put a grommet? We put a grommet in the anterior inferior segment. Whenever you are reading, whenever you are drawing the line diagram of tympanic membrane, anterior inferior ati beta, 3 points should click in your mind. Which are the 3 points? Cone of light? Yes. Meningotomy? Yes. Grommet? Yes. Here comes one more important MCQ of NEET examination. After how many months you put a grommet? 3 months, 3 months. Am I understandable? I always motivate my students to be a fast learner. And the best way to learn in a fast mode is to concise the things. Wherever you are getting the word anterior inferior, you should hit. It is cone of flight? Yes. Meningotomy? Yes. Grommet? Yes. Am I understandable? Are you getting this point? Now here comes all my third year students who are going for VIVA examination. If I'm your examiner, I will ask you, beta, how you will differentiate right side of tympanic membrane from the left. Important concept, beta. 5 o'clock, 7 o'clock. Always remember, beta. If cone of light is coming at 5 o'clock in a clock, if it is coming at 5, it is your right side. If it is coming at 7, it is your left side. Maybe possibility you forget in the examination hall. This is the alphabet L. You rotate it, it becomes 7. You will never forget. Am I understandable? 7 is for left. 5 is for right. But you people are under a big pressure of 19 subjects. Examination hall mein kuch bhi ho sakta, kuch bhi ho sakta. So just remember, you rotate the alphabet L, you will get 7. These things will come when you will focus. But this is what I am teaching you, is the hard earned efforts of last 15 years, which we are sharing with you. Am I understandable? So cone of light. Now just try to appreciate everyone, every student. Which are the 3 reliable markers? If any faculty from AIIMS comes for your VIVA, they will say, which are the 3 important reliable markers? Always remember, AMBO. Yes, what is AMBO? Most concave part. Can you focus? This area is the most concave part. This area is known as AMBO. AMBO. One is cone of light is a reliable marker. What do you mean by reliable marker, beta? Reliable marker, beta. Whenever we see these points, we label middle ear is normal, tympanic membrane is normal. Are you getting the concept? Cone of light. And what is the third reliable marker? Anyone, any student who can update in the chat box? Yes, Dr. Hema is replying. Dr. Shikha, Ambo, yes. Cone of light. And last is handle of malleus. Handle of malleus. These are the 3 important reliable markers. Now you are going for INICT and the examiner asks you, which is the best reliable marker? Always choose AMBO. AMBO is the best reliable marker. AMBO is the best reliable marker of tympanic membrane. Now let us learn on a single image, beta, how we can learn all the important pathological points of tympanic membrane. Everyone, focus your eyes on the board. Let us start. What is this area? This is my earwax. If you see something brownish, yellowish segment, this is your impacted earwax. Agreed. So this is a big perforation visible to me. Yes, which part of the tympanic membrane? I can see it is somewhere posterior superior segment. Posteriorly, yes, this is my perforation. What is this patch? Any student who can tell me, any student who is preparing for INICT examination, what is this, beta? Anyone, any student, what is this? Can you comment? What is this I'm showing you? This is some whitish patch on the tympanic membrane, white patch on the tympanic membrane with a history of any trauma 2-3 years back. I will label it as tympanosclerosis. Tympanosclerosis. If you are going for INICT examination, they can show you a white patch on the tympanic membrane and they can ask you what is the cause of tympanosclerotic patch. Always remember frequent uses of grommet. Whenever we use grommet, we are having a risk of tympanosclerosis. Very good, beta. One of the students have replied tympanosclerosis, which may complicate cholesteroma. Yes, one of the students have replied cholesteroma word in the chat box. This is your perforation. Always remember the golden statement, any perforation which is touching margin, which is touching the margin of tympanic membrane, marginal perforation, very poor prognosis. Golden statement, beta. If any perforation is touching the margins, we label it as marginal perforation. We label it as marginal perforation. Coming on the next segment, we have done mastery of a normal tympanic membrane. This is your normal tympanic membrane. How can you label it normal? Sir, handle of malleus visible. Sir, cone of light, yes sir, visible. At which position? Sir, 7 o'clock. It means is a left tympanic membrane. Agreed. Cone of light, yes. Handle of malleus, yes. Ambo, yes. I will label it as, you are a dance student, you will label it as normal. This is normal. Now, you compare this slide with the next one. There is a reddish mass in the lower part. And the examiner is using a keyword, beta. Aaj hum ek promise karenge, we will never have the phobia of this clinical vignettes, beta. No phobia should be there. Just apply the common sense. If you have revised the notes 4-5 times, you will click on the keywords, and which keyword will be there? The examiner will say, there is a pulsatile mass. Yes, there is a pulsatile mass. Now, I'm your examiner. Let us crack this topic now. There is a reddish tympanic membrane. You can appreciate the redness of the tympanic membrane. The examiner is using the word pulsatile. I will go for glomus tumor. Absolutely, yes. Yes, very nice, Dr. Radhe. It is glomus jugular. Very nice response coming in the chat box. Excellent, beta. It is pulsatile tumor. Now, if I am using the word pregnancy, reddish tympanic membrane. Yes, which word should click in your mind? Pregnant female, red tympanic membrane. No second thought. Orthosclerosis. Are you getting the concept, beta? So just try to compare. Try to appreciate the keywords, beta. If the examiner is using the word pulsatile, he will be for glomus tumor. If he is talking about pregnancy, we'll go for orthosclerosis. This is known as, if the glomus tumor pulsatile mass is there, which other two MCQs they can ask you is known as rising sun sign. Yes, excellent. Rising sun sign. Now you compare. The next slide, we are just doing the mastery of the different type of tympanic membrane. Now you focus your eyes on this tympanic membrane, beta. What you are seeing, I am seeing a bluish tympanic membrane. The word blue, if the word blue is there in the examination hall, always go with serous otitis media. If the word blue is there, we will go for serous otitis media. Bluish tympanic membrane. Going for serous otitis media, what will be the treatment of choice? First will be myringotomy, not responding. I will be going for grommet insertion. Dr. Chandan, it's just one page you can leave and just continue. Later on, you can see this video again. But I'm saying in this image, I'm showing you different type of tympanic membrane, all the potential MCQs which can be there. There are blebs on the tympanic membrane here. Blebs on the tympanic membrane. Clear? So these are small blebs. Can you see small bubbles on the tympanic membrane? We use a word, multiple blebs on the tympanic membrane. Now compare the last image. Focus your eyes. I'm waiting for a response in the chat box. Any student who can reply, what is this one? This is your retracted tympanic membrane. Always make a golden statement. If you appreciate something more than malleus in a normal tympanic membrane, we always get malleus, but in retracted tympanic membrane you will be getting more than malleus. You may get the image of incus or stapes. Retracted tympanic membrane, this is your retracted. Just make a concept, beta. If what is the concept of retracted tympanic membrane? If this is normal tympanic membrane, if it is bulging out, I use a word. If it is moving out, bulging tympanic membrane. Whenever there is a extra fluid in the middle ear or extra pus in the middle ear, you will be getting bulging tympanic membrane. When it is moving inside, we use a word, retracted tympanic membrane. Retracted tympanic membrane. Golden statement, retraction can be, just remember this point, beta. Retraction can be, one of the student, Dr. Kancha, is asking blebs in, beta. It can be mycoplasma etiology, it can be viral etiology, where we get multiple small blebs on the tympanic membrane.
Absolutely, yes. It is ET tube, eustachian tube blockage, the most common cause of retracted tympanic membrane is ET dysfunction. Absolutely right. One of the students updated in the chat box. Retraction can be in the par flaccida, and if it is in the par flaccida, we use which classification? We use TOS classification, beta, TOS classification. And if I want to explain the retraction of par tensa, we use SADA classification. So we should be confident of two important words, TOS classification, by nice response coming in the chat box. TOS classification for the par flaccida and for tensa is a SADA classification. Now, concentrate on this image now. In your middle ear, three ossicles are floating. Always remember, your middle ear is not symmetrical as your room. Your room is a symmetrical box. This is your tympanic membrane. This is your premonitory middle wall. Any of the student can reply in the chat box, how can you convert a symmetrical box into middle ear? Common sense, we should pressurize the medial wall and lateral wall. If I press the medial wall and lateral wall together, I will get a perfect middle ear, beta. I will get this type of image. If I compress the tympanic membrane with premonitory. So if this is my tympanic membrane, this is my premonitory. This is the actual image of my middle ear. I use a word biconcave concept. You must have read in your 12th standard. With this line diagram, very good, very nice. Dr. Hema is updating in the chat box. All the mnemonics I am teaching in the class. Very nice. Tympanic membrane, premonitory. The uppermost part, obviously, is known as epitympanum. The middle part is known as mesotympanum. This is known as hypotympanum. Excellent. What is the width of epitympanum? Always remember, 6 mm. Meso is the narrowest portion. And what is the width of mesotympanum? 2 mm. 6 minus 2 is 4 mm is hypotympanum. Beta, 3 MCQs in a single go. Epitympanum is widest portion. Is your 6 mm. Mesotympanum is 2 mm. Hypotympanum is your 4 mm is your 4 mm. This is the orientation of my biconcave middle ear. Now let us do mastery of ossicles. Three ossicles are there in the middle ear: malleus, incus, tapes, beta. Focus your eyes on the board. Everyone stop writing. Later on you can see this video again on YouTube and you can write all the notes. Concentrate on the board now. Beta, this area, this is my malleus. This is the head of the malleus. This is neck of the malleus. This is handle of the malleus. What is the other name of handle of malleus? I use a word manubrium of the malleus, which is visible from outside. Again, revise with me, every student. Malleus divided into three major parts: head of the malleus, neck of the malleus, handle of the malleus. What is the other name of handle? We use a word manubrium of the malleus. Manubrium of the malleus. Now, what is this one? This is your incus. We divide into further three parts: short process of incus, this area is body of incus, and long process of incus. What is the other name of long process of incus? We call it as lenticular process. The third ossicle, which is stapes, is further divided into two parts. One is foot plate of the stapes, one is suprastructure of the stapes, beta. Suprastructure. So if I draw a simple line diagram for you of stapes, this is my foot plate and above is your suprastructure, which is further divided into anterior part and posterior part. Let us crack few MCQs now. Everyone focus your eyes on the board. If I show you this image, what is the importance of handle of malleus? Now, I'm giving you multiple MCQs on this image. Let us crack. Now, focus your eyes. Beta, what is the importance of this area? X. The importance is visible from outside. Is a reliable marker for normal tympanic membrane. Agreed, sir. Second point, second MCQ. If the examiner make a cross at this point, what is the importance of long process? Every student, is the most common site for neck. Necrosis. Always remember, is the most common site for necrosis. That second MCQ, lenticular process, long process, most common site for necrosis. The third MCQ, every student should reply, beta, which nerve I am drawing for you, which nerve is being drawn? Anyone, any student who can tell me which nerve is moving between malleus and incus? Which nerve is moving? Yes, absolutely yes. Is cauda tympana. Is cauda tympana, which, where Dr. Ashwini, it is not facial, it is a branch of facial, cauda tympana. Excellent. Everybody is responding nicely. The fourth MCQ. What is the importance of this area now? Any student, what is the importance of this area? If the examiner label it X, what is X? Foot plate. What is the importance of foot plate? Is the importance is the most common site for involvement of otosclerosis. Most common site for otosclerosis. This foot plate is attached with the oval window. The next MCQ. Everybody focus your eyes on the board. What is the importance of this area? What is the importance of this area? Any student? What I am showing you? I am showing you a joint between incus and stapes. A joint between incus and stapes. Incidostapedial joint, yes, is the most common site for trauma. If there is any trauma in the middle ear, always remember which joint is easily damaged is your incidostapedial joint. What is incidostapedial joint? What is which type of joint is there? Ball and socket joint. Excellent. Nice response coming in the chat box. What is this joint? This is a joint with more surface area, incidomalear joint. Whenever there is a trauma in the middle ear, this is the last to be damaged. This joint is last to be damaged. Incidomalear, which is a type of incidomalear, always remember saddle joint. So your malleus, which is derived from the word hammer, is having saddle joint, while incus is making ball and socket. In this 50 to 60 minutes, beta, I am teaching you how to approach the conceptual learning, beta. If you are drawing the line diagram, can you appreciate? From 9:30, I am just drawing. I am showing you the line diagrams. Always believe in drawing the line diagrams, beta. No need of making any artistic diagram. Things are very simple. So just draw simple line diagrams. What is fossa incidus? If the examiner used this word, is a depression on the short process of incus. If this is my incus, this area we call it as fossa incidus. We use a word fossa incidus. Clear? Now I'm showing you this line diagram again. Cauda tympani moving between malleus and incus. Cauda tympani moving between malleus incus. Clear? Coming on the next one. After doing mastery of ossicle, yes, I am showing you one MCQ from your AIIMS question bank. They have shown you the three ossicle. What is the important, most important site? What is being pointed out? I am showing out is your lenticular process, beta, long process. So answer will be your most common site of necrosis. Anyone? Most common site of cholestoma. Cholestoma is a squamous debris in the middle ear. If it is squamous debris in the middle ear, which area will be the right answer? This segment. If examiner highlight this area, any student who can reply in the chat box, before asking the question, the students are replying in the chat box. Excellent, beta. This is the beauty of DAM student. This area is Prusik space. Most common site for cholestoma formation. So option A is your Prusik space. Most common site of facial palsy. Facial palsy can be, where is the entry of the facial nerve? Always remember the golden statement, facial nerve enter at oval window. Just remember, next to oval window, there is an area, processus coccoliformis. And what is the fourth option? D option, most common site of otosclerosis is your foot plate. Am I understanding? I'm not going in the depth of facial now because I want to restrict myself to the middle ear. So I'm teaching you the high yielding concepts of middle ear. So this area, again, I'm showing you 3D orientation of ossicle, malleus, incus, stapes. This area is very important for ENT surgeon. This is Prusik space, is the most common site for cholestoma formation. Most common site for cholestoma formation is your Prusik space. I'm very happy everybody is responding. Dr. Bhavya, processus coccoliformis, I will explain. Just give me a few minutes, but I will be explaining. After learning this concept of Prusik space, what is the importance of incus? I have two important concepts. whenever we remove the stapes, we attach a prosthesis to the lenticular process. So a patient of otosclerosis, all the students who are going for upcoming INICT examination, always remember this point. In otosclerosis, when you remove the stapes, we keep a prosthesis, and that prosthesis is attached with, this prosthesis is attached with lenticular process. Always remember this concept. Everybody please write in the notes, after stapedectomy, when we remove the stapes, excellent. This is the best reply coming from Dr. Katyar. It is your Robinson prosthesis, beta. Excellent. One of my favorite question in TND is Robinson prosthesis. What is Robinson prosthesis? Is attached with the lenticular process. In which patient? After surgery of stapes. After surgery of stapes, we keep a prosthesis known as Robinson prosthesis. Robinson prosthesis. In a patient of CSOM, tubotympanic patient, that is safe ear, we use artificial prosthesis, beta. So that is known as total ossicular replacement prosthesis and partial os. I am teaching you the importance of incus, where the incus is the right answer. In a few MCQs they can ask you, in otosclerosis after stapedectomy we are keeping a artificial prosthesis known by the name of Robinson, where we attach Robinson prosthesis on the lenticular process. On the lenticular process, one more important concept, beta. Nowadays we are using semi-implantable middle ear devices, is a modified version of hearing aid, beta, next level of hearing aid, where we are using a prosthesis attached with the incus. We have a prosthesis which is used for deaf patient. If any deaf patient comes to me, we can have semi-implantable middle ear devices, which is known as VORP, beta, vibrating ossicular prosthesis. Vibrating ossicular prosthesis, very potential MCQ for upcoming INICT examination. The important component of VORP, vibrating, beta, where we are? We are in middle ear, we are learning the importance of incus. What are the uses of incus? One important point, after stapedectomy, we keep an artificial prosthesis, agreed. Second, we can use for keeping PORP, TORP, partial ossicular replacement prosthesis, total ossicular replacement prosthesis. I'm teaching you all the clinical applied concepts of middle ear. Now, for deaf patients, we are using VORP, vibrating ossicular prosthesis, beta. Nowadays, we are keeping these type of prosthesis. Now, I will be just showing you. Focus your eyes on the board, beta. These type of nice processes are there, which will be used for deaf patient, beta, deaf patient. Now focus your eyes on the board. Just wait for 1 second. Can you see? I'm just keeping a device instead of keeping the device in the external auditory canal. I am keeping the device, I am just attached to the incus. This is your lenticular process of incus, and here we are. I am showing you again, beta. Just try to appreciate. This is a latest technology for using for hearing rehabilitation. Again, everyone, can you appreciate, beta? We are keeping a prosthesis. We are attached a prosthesis to the lenticular process of incus, lenticular process of incus. Coming back, this device is known as vibrating ossicular prosthesis. Vibrating ossicular prosthesis. Visible. Dr. Shetty classes till 10:30. Beta. I will be taking few couple of minutes to teach you the all concepts of middle ear. Now focus your eyes on the board, beta. We are sitting in the middle ear. Everyone, do imagination with me. We people are sitting in the middle ear. We remove the medial wall. When I remove the medial wall, everybody should reply in the chat box. If I remove the medial wall, what I will appreciate? If I remove the medial wall, if I remove the promontory, if I remove the medial wall of middle ear, I will appreciate which component? I will appreciate the inner ear. Now, imagination. We are sitting. Everybody do imagination with me. All my third year student, foundation students. You are sitting in the middle ear and we remove the medial wall. Once we remove the medial wall, again, appreciate, beta, we are removing the medial wall. Once we remove the medial wall, you will get a image of inner ear. This is my oval window. Now focus your eyes on this area. What is the importance of oval window? Here is your stapes attachment. Am I understandable? And this area below is your round window, which is covered by secondary tympanic membrane. We use the word secondary tympanic membrane. What is the importance of round window? Anybody who can write in the chat box, what is the importance of round window? R for round, R for releasing the pressure. So is a pressure releaser, is a pressure releaser of inner ear. Always remember, beta, is pressure releaser of inner ear. Like ET tube release the pressure from the middle ear, and the same mechanism, your round window is releasing the pressure from inner ear. Oval window, the other name for oval window we people are using is fenestra vestibuli, while round window we are using the word fenestra cochlea. Clear? So these are the few important terms. Tympanic plexus. What is tympanic plexus? Is a plexus of the nerve fiber. Which nerve fibers? Ninth nerve and tenth nerve. So if the examiner asks you, your middle ear is supplied by, your middle ear is supplied by two important nerves, ninth nerve, tenth nerve. They combine to form a plexus known as tympanic plexus. Always remember, where is this plexus present? This plexus is present on premonitory. Very nice response coming on the chat box. This is your premonitory beta. Clear? The fiber of ninth nerve, we use a word Jacobson nerve, and fiber of tenth nerve, we use a word Arnold nerve. Excellent. Everybody is responding. So just remember, two important nerves supplying your middle ear, ninth nerve, tenth nerve, combined to form tympanic plexus, which is on premonitory. Fiber of ninth nerve, Jacobson fibers. Fiber of tenth nerve, Arnold fibers. Arnold fibers. Coming to the next one. Yes. Now appreciate the anterior wall beta. On anterior wall of middle ear. On the anterior wall. If this is my middle ear, this is your plexus. Can you appreciate which plexus I'm showing you on premonitory? This is my tympanic plexus. Agreed, everyone? Now do imagination with me. Thanks, Dr. Shetty, for the compliment in the chat box. Now focus your eyes on the board. On anterior wall is your ET tube. Eustachian tube is there. Where is the other end? It is opening into nasopharynx. Worth remembering point. It is opening into nasopharynx. The part which is attached with the part which is attached with the middle ear. Always remember, the part which, one second, part which is attached with the middle ear, part which is attached with the middle ear is your bony part, is your bony part. Part which is attached to the nasopharynx is your cartilage part, is the cartilaginous part. Clear? This is ET tube. I am waiting for a response in the chat box. We are waiting for a response in the chat box. What is this area known as? I am confident all my students will reply. A part of the middle ear surrounding, part of the middle ear surrounding your ET tube. Anyone who can reply in the chat box? No, beta, fossa of frozen will appear. Dr. Pandey, where is fossa? I am talking about the area in the middle ear, area in the middle ear which is surrounding the ET tube, middle ear. Excellent, Dr. Bhavya, it is protympanum. Protympanum, excellent response coming in the chat box. Protympanum. Now just try to learn, beta. I am going to teach you a line diagram of middle ear. This line diagram will help you in upcoming days. Focus your eyes on the board. This is a middle ear. Do imagination with me, everyone. I am confident, beta, in this way, when you are drawing multiple line diagram, it is very easy to revise again and again. Now focus your eyes on the board, beta. If this is my middle ear, if this is my middle ear, this is my tympanic membrane, this is my medial wall. Every student sitting with me, just orient yourself. Tympanic membrane, medial wall, this is your anterior wall, this is your posterior wall. Every student, focus your eyes on the board. Three ossicles are sitting in the middle ear. Three ossicles are sitting in the middle ear, malleus, incus, stapes. This stapes attached with the oval window. Yes, agreed, is attached with the oval window. Now focus your eyes on the board, everyone, every student, focus your eyes on the board. From stapes, stapedius muscle, S for straight muscle, S for seven. Everyone, just stop writing. This area, yeah, very good. Dr. Sharma is asking, what is this area? Is this rectangle is? Beta, just do imagination. You are sitting with me. You are sitting with me on the roof of the middle ear. We are sitting in the middle cranial fossa. You and me both are sitting in the middle cranial fossa, and we are appreciating the middle ear from above. Everyone, close your eyes, listen to my statement. We all are sitting in the middle cranial fossa, and we are appreciating the middle ear from superior side. Beta, Dr. Anand Sharma, just reply in the chat box. You got the orientation? You are sitting in the middle cranial fossa, and we are having a superior view. We are getting a view from above of the middle ear. Malleus, interstapes, that is your old window. S for stapes, S for stapedius, S for straight, S for seventh. No. Is supplied by seventh nerve, stapedius muscle, is attached posteriorly, known as pyramid. This is your pyramid. Am I understandable? This is your pyramid. Now from malleus, the second muscle is coming. The second muscle is starting from malleus, going to the promontory. Actually, God has gifted a very long length of tensor tympani. So what ENT people are doing, they are wasting the extra length given by God. So the God has gifted it more length of the tensor tympani, and what I am doing, I am starting from malleus, I am going to promontory, I am taking a U-turn, I am coming back, I attach on the anterior wall. Now you can focus your eyes, this is your tensor tympani attachment. Now this area from where the tensor tympani take a U-turn, is known as processus coccoliformis. This is known as processus coccoliformis. So where is processus coccoliformis, beta? This area anterior to oval window. If I am standing on the medial wall, always everyone, every student concentrate. If I am standing on the medial wall, the first two important stations, I always teach in my lecture in this way. This is a red metro line. On the metro line, the first metro station is processus coccoliformis. Second metro station, you are moving posteriorly, is your oval window. Third, I will be teaching you next 2 minutes. Am I understandable? So on this line diagram, I am teaching you the motor supply of middle ear, beta. Isse pehle humne kya yaad kiya tha? Sensory supply. What is sensory supply? Ninth nerve, tenth nerve. I am teaching you the motor supply. Motor is your seventh nerve, and T for tensor tympani, T for trigeminal is your fifth nerve. So never get confused. Motor supply is equal to 5 plus 7. Sensory supply is 9 plus 10. Am I understandable? These formulas will help you to crack all the one-liners, all the important concepts. Absolutely yes, is your coming from the trunk of the tensor tympani. Tensor tympani is supplied by the nerve coming from the trunk of your trigeminal. Excellent. Am I understandable? This line diagram is absolutely clear. So on the anterior wall, I am having the ET tube, I am having the attachment of tensor tympani. Now let us focus the posterior wall. Now focus your eyes on the posterior wall. If this area is my middle ear, anteriorly is an ET tube, this is anterior, so this area is posterior wall. This posteriorly, what is behind middle ear, always make a concept, is known as mastoid. So this area is known as mastoid. Am I understandable? And what is the beauty of middle ear and mastoid? They both are communicating with each other. Just try to learn better this concept now. This communication is in which part? If you are my third year student, I will be asking you this question in Viva, which part of the middle ear is communicating with the mastoid? You will say, sir, it is the upper part. So beta, which statement is a better statement? Listen, everyone, every student, close your eyes, listen carefully. Which statement is better statement? Middle ear is communicating with mastoid, or apotympanum is communicating with mastoid? Everyone will say, it's a better statement, apotympanum. But I am teaching you as if you are my 10th standard student. I am not expecting anything from you except apply common sense. So which is a better statement? Better statement is apotympanum. Apotympanum is communicating with mastoid. Agreed? Now I am just making you familiar with it. Whatever I am teaching in 2 to 3 hours, I am just trying my best to teach all those concepts in a fast mode in 1 hour. Just to give you a message, line diagrams, keywords, integrated learning is the future. Take my word, brother. We have to learn in an integrated way. Whenever you are learning the concept of ENT, you have to complete anatomy part. Whenever you are learning the medicine surgery, take my word, brother. Key first year, second year subjects, very crucial. And being a third year student or being a final year or intern student is not practically possible for me to touch the second year books now or first year books now. So
for all these scenario, for the changing pattern, our director Dr. Sumer have come with a new concept of integrated learning. Beta, we have to learn topic wise. What is the future? Where we have to learn system wise, topic wise. I will take one topic, respiratory system, I will complete the whole topic. I'm taking the anatomy part, I will complete the whole anatomy, and I will add all the important keywords, all the clinical points on the line diagram. If a student asks me, okay, which is the most crucial topics for next pattern, take my word, is the second year, which we have to learn in an integrated way. We have to read medicine, but in an integrated way, so that later on we should get the confidence that, yeah, I have completed my patho, pharma, micro, and administrative. So first year, second year subjects should be learned in a very integrated way, which is our plan of action for the next upcoming days. Clear? So, epitympanum. What is the other name of epitympanum? Thanks, Beta, for giving compliment in the chat box. These line diagrams helps a lot. Coming on the next point. Attic. What is the other name of attic? Epitympanum, Beta. Epitympanum. And on this platform, I want to give you a strong message, Beta. Comfort zone se bahar aana hai. Next 2 years, no comfort. Nothing, Beta. We have to take pain. We have to take efforts, Beta. Either the time name is Krishna. Just focus on the studies, Beta. Epitympanum, attic. What is the other name of mastoid? We use a word, antrum. We use a word, antrum. What is adductus? Everyone, close your eyes, speak out adductus. When you speak out adductus, you get a feeling of duct. Yes, I call it as duct of the middle ear and mastoid, adductus. So I'm just making you familiar with the three words: attic, epitympanum, duct, adductus, and mastoid is antrum. At this point, I will write one more word, M for mastoid, M for maxillary sinus. In my ENT, where I am using antrum, I am using antrum in two segments. One is your ear, is your mastoid. In your nose, we are using for maxillary sinus. Coming back, what is C, what is B, what is A? Line, three important MCQs for you. Common sense, you are the master of the game now. This area, C, what is C? Stapes, yes. What is B? B is a muscle, that is stapedius. What is A? A is your pyramid. Again, this is what we have learned. Where is the pyramid? Pyramid is on the posterior wall. Next 5 minutes, very crucial. Next 5 minutes, very crucial. Excellent. This Dr. Radhe, he have given a comment in the chat box. C word, alphabet C is equal to stapes. Every student, close your eyes, just mug up this statement. Alphabet C is stapes. Alphabet C stapes. It will help you to crack endoscopic MCQs, all the MCQs related with endoscopic image of the middle ear, which I'm showing you in the next 1 minute. Always remember with us, alphabet C is equal to stapes. Concentrate on the board now. Now I want to take you to the next level of line diagram. Concentrate on the board. Every student, we are drawing the same concept but in a different way now. If this is my middle ear, again, if this is my middle ear, malleus, incus, stapes. Now I'm just making you familiar with the two more important terms. And this is a stapes, this is a oval window, the second metrostation. The first metrostation is somewhere anteriorly. This is your anterior one. This is your posterior one. This is my processus coccyphalus. This is my stapedius. Agreed. Now focus your eyes on this area. Now you focus your eyes on this area. Where is this area located? This area is somewhere at the junction of medial wall and posterior wall. My ENT HOD is saying this area is a narrow space. When it is a narrow space, it is very difficult to clean this area. If it is difficult to clean this area before starting the topic, when I learn the concept, it's difficult to clean this area, I will label it as is a most common site for residual disease. Whenever there is any pus in the middle ear or any pathology in the middle ear, I will not be able to clean this area. Residual, most common site for residual, where? It's a junction of medial wall and posterior wall. What is this known as? We use a word. Excellent response coming in the chat box, Beta. It means you people are revising everything nicely Instead of running behind multiple sources, you are revising one gold standard class notes, sinus tympani. Yes, this is known as sinus tympani. Most common site for residual disease. Most common site for reoccurrence. Beta, साथ में एक और MCQ याद कर लेते हैं. Most common site. अगर आप कुछ छोड़ोगे, तो वो बाद में फिर आपको परेशान करेगा. It will again come back. Yes, residual reoccurrence. Am I understandable? Are you getting this point? जितनी मेहनत करनी है. Next few couple of days we should do and we get a decent branch, decent rank in All India AIIMS examination. Next couple of months, beta, mehnat mein no compromise. You should not be in your comfort zone. Clear? Otherwise, lifelong you will be disturbed. So always clean the middle ear completely. Even sinus tympani should be clean completely. Always remember this point. Clear? Coming back. So which are the three metro stations running on the medial wall is processus coccoliformis, oval window and sinus tympani. This area is sinus tympani. Agreed? Now, every student should reply, what is this nerve I am showing you? Here, which nerve enter from the processus coccoliformis? Yes, with the help of this line diagram, you will help me. Which is a nerve which is coming from inner ear to middle ear to mastoid is your facial nerve. This is your facial nerve. Are you getting the concept? This is your facial nerve. And from facial nerve, your cauda tympani is going back into the middle ear. This is your cauda tympani. So with respect to your pyramid, my favorite question, everyone should reply. With respect to pyramid, your facial nerve is slightly medial, while cauda tympani is slightly lateral. Slightly lateral. I hope you people are getting my concepts, beta. Now I will make it more clear to you. Just focus your eyes, beta. I am cleaning up. I am just concentrate again. Focus your eyes, beta. I am again drawing a line diagram for you, and you people should help me to label the structures now. If you do this type of exercise, beta, again, I just want to give a message on this platform. These things are very simple, beta. Malleus incrustatus. Now I want to teach you important landmarks. You people should reply, what is number 1, what is number 2, what is number 3, what is number 4, number 5, number 6. If you reply, my aim is over. Number 1, everybody, what is number 1, what is number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6. Every student should reply. But if you have done this, my aim is over. The whole sole aim of organizing this session was, you just tell me, what is A? Number 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. Processus coccoliformis. Excellent. Number 2. Oval window. Yes. Number 3. Sinus tympani. Excellent. Number 4. Facial nerve. Yes. Number 5. Pyramid. Number 6. Cauda tympani. Excellent. That is what is required. Fast learner always win the match, beta. If you can label number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, my aim is over. 1. Processus coccoliformis. Oval window, I hope everybody is enjoying. Kindly revert back in the chat box. Thumbs up. Everybody enjoying the session? Processus coccoliformis, oval window, sinus tympani, facial nerve, pyramid, cauda tympani. I want every student attending the lecture should revert back in the chat box. You got the concept, beta. This was the only mess aim of this session. I just want to teach you this concept. If you can learn these dots, beta, if you can learn these dots, nobody can stop you in getting good rank in All India AIIMS examination. Thanks for updating in the chat box, beta. This is what is required for your INICT examination. Never ever have the phobia of INICT, beta. Damn student, take my word, beta. For damn student, nothing is impossible. INICT, beta, bachcho ka khel hai, because keyword. Clear? Thanks for giving. Yeah, this is a game. This is an image which is given in your books, and this is a very disturbing image. Most of the students, they find difficulty in this image. Now, I take you to my OT now. Let us get it. Beta, Dr. Shetty, thanks for the feedback. We will organize these sessions on frequent basis, beta. Definitely we will do. We are taking your feedback, beta. Now, focus your eyes on the board. This was the MCQ. Alphabet C. Always identify with the alphabet C. Whenever the alphabet C is there, it is stapes. Where is the alphabet C? Just focus your eyes. This is the alphabet C, beta. This is very, for beta, they hope. For a beginner, for a foundation student, for a foundation student, this is nothing but red and gray. But for dance students, now you will label all these structures. You will label all these structures. This is alphabet C. Alphabet C is stapes. Agreed? If this is your stapes, it means this is oval window. Yes. If this is oval window, what will be beneath? So there will be long window. Agreed? And if this is your stapes, obviously which muscle will be attached? This will be your stapedius. Will be your stapedius. Am I understandable? Are you getting this part? So what is the nutshell of this game? Nutshell of this game is alphabet C is equal to stapes. If you understand alphabet C is stapes, the whole game is over. Clear? Coming back. Beta, always remember, just make a promise to me. Be proud to be a doctor. Every day in the morning when you wake up, just give 5 minutes and close your eyes. Thanks your family, thanks your parents, okay, you are a doctor. One of the best profession in the whole world. Always feel proud to be a doctor, Beta. Always feel proud. When you get this type, when you show gratitude to the God in the morning, take my word, you will get positive energy and you will work hard in the whole day. The same thing we people are doing, Beta. We people are doing the same thing. Every day in the morning, we feel proud to be a doctor. We get a positive energy to work hard in the whole day. Am I understandable? Are you getting this point? Don't quit. All my intern, post-intern listening to me, Beta, dhyan se sunna. Everybody is under big pressure. Nobody is confident given the all dates will be declared or all this COVID scenario will be over. But take my word, don't quit. Everybody is under mental pressure, but this hard days, Beta, jo ye difficult days hain, it will help you in the rest of your life. I'm not talking about your rank, Beta. 10 years down the lane, you will be so mentally strong that you will win, you will tackle each and every problem of your life. So be proud. And whenever there is an issue, always that issue is trying to teach you something. So it is making you mentally very strong. And take my word, Beta, don't quit. In the upcoming days, prepare for INICT examination. I have seen many students, they say, I am from an average medical college, I am an average student, I cannot crack INICT. Forget it, Beta. Just work hard 24/7, come out of your comfort zone, you will definitely get good rank. Try your best to enter in the Central Institute, Beta. What is the biggest advantage of Central Institute? Next 3 years, there will be some faculty to teach you, Beta. In next 3 years, when you enter in AIIMS or Jipmer or Pondicherry, take my words, there will be the faculty who will be the inspiration, motivation for you. They will teach you so nicely that you will enjoy the rest of your life. Make a promise in the chat box that we will work hard to enter in the Central Institute, Beta. Main is tarah ka koi aim nahi rakhunga ki jo mil gaya main le lunga. I will go to the Central Institute. I will work hard. Thanks a lot for listening to me, Beta. You people can have Zoom sessions with me anytime. We can discuss all these strategies for the upcoming days. Thanks a lot for listening to me. Thanks a lot. We stop at this point. Best wishes.